Sa DZRH, sa Elizalde.
Forget the past, it's time to mend.
A corporate, same.
So, ang sinasabi ko na lang.
Isang mapayapang hapon, Pilipinas. Narito ang inyong balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Makuha, na bumabati sa lahat ng nakikinig sa DZRH at nanonood sa RHTV. Lalong-lalo na sa ating mga kasamahang alagad ng sining at kultura sa buong bansa. Sa hapong ito, kikilalanin natin ang isang napakahusay na Filipino-American actor na matagal nang umaani ng tagumpay sa iba't ibang proyekto sa New York, bago siya nagpasyang bumalik pansamantala sa Pilipinas. Pagdating dito, kaliwat-kanan din ang kanyang film and television projects na nagdala din sa kanya ng di-iilang acting awards. Nagkaroon din siya ng television series sa Singapore kung saan naging Best Actor nominee siya sa International Emmy Awards noong 2012. O diba, nakakataba ng puso para sa ating mga kababayan. Hashtag Philippine Pride. Kaya't huwag kayong aalis dahil kalahating oras ng masayang kwentuhan ang hatid namin sa inyo sa hapong ito. Kasama ang premiadong aktor na si Ginoong Art Acuña.
Isinilang at lumaki sa Maynila, tumulak papuntang Amerika si Arthur Acuña noong 1986 upang makipagsapalaran bilang aktor. Sa New York City, kumuha siya ng mga specialized courses tulad ng acting for the camera, film technique, Shakespeare, Morris Method, pati na mga vocal at speech lessons. Nagbunga ang kanyang pagpupunyagi nang di maglaon nakakuha siya ng acting roles sa mga sikat na television drama sa Amerika tulad ng Law and Order, Criminal Intent, Third Watch, As the World Turns, One Life to Live, at Stella. Bukod pa dito, naging aktibo din siya sa larangan ng teatro at umani ng tagumpay sa mga dulang tulad ng Bike Wreck, Whisper House, Ghost Written, The Romance of Magno Rubio, 2 September, The Passion Play, Lil Brown Brothers, Romeo and Juliet, Dog Eaters, Ivanov, at marami pang iba. Bagamat matagal nang nakabase sa Amerika, patuloy ding gumagawa ng mga proyekto sa Pilipinas si Art, lalo na sa telebisyon at independent films. Naging bahagi siya ng mga teleseryeng Princess and I, The Legal Wife, at Maria del Barrio, at lumabas sa mga Cinemalaya entries tulad ng David F., The Diplomat Hotel, Posas, at Nino. Naging bida rin siya sa Singaporean TV production ng The Kitchen Musical, kung saan naging nominado siya bilang Best Actor sa International Emmy Awards at sa Asian TV Awards noong 2012. Ilan sa mga gantimpalang natanggap na niya ay ang Obie Award New York City para sa Romance of Magno Rubio, Cinemanila International Film Festival Best Actor para sa Batang West Side, ang 2011 Cinemalaya, 2012 Gawad Orian, at 2012 Golden Screen and Press Best Supporting Actor Awards para sa Nino, at ang 2012 Cinemalaya at 2013 Gawad Orian Best Supporting Actor Awards para sa Posas. Isang mainit na pagbati ang hatid ng Art to Art sa premyadong aktor ng pelikula, telebisyon at tanghalan na si Ginoong Art Acuña.
Art, welcome to Art to Art.
Salamat, Lisa.
O, diba? Literally, hindi na artist to artist, talagang artist to art.
Tama,
o, diba?
Sabi nga nung kaibigan ko, nasa art to art si art.
Oo nga. You're okay. Made for this program.
I think so.
Yes.
It was meant to happen.
Okay, so I guess magbalik tanaw muna tayo, no? Una sa lahat. Kailan mo unang parang na-discover for yourself na gusto mong maging isang aktor?
Naramdaman ko ito nung nasa Lasal pa ako. Nag-drama guild ako sa Lasal.
Mm-hmm.
So, gumawa ako ng dalawang productions doon. After that, SRO Philippines under mm-hmm. Roxanne Lapus.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Tinanong ako kung gusto ko mag-professional production. Mm. Sabi ko, okay, pakiramdam ko noon, hindi pa ako sa level na yun na kaya ko na ba ito? Mm-hmm. Pero sabi ko, sige, subukan natin.
Mm-hmm.
So sinubukan ko, tapos noon nag-rep na ako for one season lang.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, I got unhappy with mm-hmm. how I felt about it. Sabi ko, may hahanap pa rin ako. No?
Pero, so it was theater muna?
It was theater.
Theater muna, oh, hindi theater muna talaga. Television at saka no. pelikula?
No, no. Mm-hmm. Hindi ko iniisip yung television at pelikula. No? Mm-hmm. Talagang theater lang.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay. First love ko talaga yung theater.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yes. Tapos niyan, pumunta ako ng States.
Aha.
Nag-abroad ako. Habang nandun ako.
So pumunta ka ng States dahil hindi ka masaya? Hindi ka maligaya?
Yes, hindi lang, hindi lang doon sa acting life ko. Ha. Mm. Hindi lang ako masayang tao noon.
Okay.
We all go through phases, di ba? You know, either it's teenage angst or yeah. young adulthood
so,
angst.
So, teenager ka nung nagpa siya kang pumunta sa
yes,
States?
Yes. Well, early 20s.
Early 20s.
Yes, early 20s.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Tapos habang nandun ako, nanood ako ng mga productions, ganyan-ganyan.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos inisip ko, stick muna. Uwi muna ako, tapos pagbalik ko, plano ko na magstay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tapos dun ako mag-aaral lang. Courses and stuff like that. Ang nangyari, nung bumisita yung tatay ko doon, 1 year, so mm-hmm. 1 year pa lang ako, less than 1 year pa lang, you know, bumisita siya, nagka-stroke siya,
mm-hmm.
kasama yung nanay ko.
Okay.
So, ang nanay ko, pinauwi ko. Mm-hmm. Like, she has to go home after 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
Eh. Tatay ko, pinahospital ko and everything, and of mm-hmm. course, I was working also. So, mm-hmm. kumuha ako ng kaibigan that I hired as a parang caregiver,
mm-hmm.
kasi kami lang dalawa, and then mm-hmm. I told my mom, ma, talagang yung kaisa-isa kong kapatid na babae at yung kaisa-isa kong kapatid na lalaki, kung mm-hmm. sino sa kanila ang gustong pumunta dito mm-hmm. sa US,
uh-oh.
Tulungan ako.
Uh-oh.
Para
okay.
habang natatrabaho ako, alaga si Erpat.
Mm-hmm.
And vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
Ganunan kami.
Mm-hmm.
They both came.
Mm-hmm.
So lahat kami nagtatrabaho, ganunan yan. So for 8 years, I didn't act talaga.
Mm-hmm.
Talagang,
okay.
Actually, tinanggal ko na sa isip ko. Eh.
Uh-huh.
Sabi ko, I have to maintain a certain amount of income.
Uh-oh.
And taking care of dad, who was in and out of the hospital, there were several mini strokes
so wait,
after the big one.
Saying you didn't act for 8 years while you were in the States. So,
I gave it up. Basically, I told myself.
So ano yung
the restaurant business.
Uh-huh.
The restaurant business.
I see.
And I got
okay.
so good at it. Started from as a waiter. I became a terrific bartender. Then I started managing bars, sometimes
mm-hmm.
three at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started managing restaurants too, along with that. So that's how
okay.
I learned it.
Mm-hmm.
I learned it from the ground up.
Mm-hmm.
I know how the books are done, the kitchen, mm-hmm. lahat.
Uh-huh. So wait, so going lahat. Back, your intention na ang pagpunta sa States was not to pursue your acting career?
That the first intention, tinanggal ko na yun.
Ah,
yeah, after
I see.
Dad got sick,
okay.
tinanggal ko na yun. And for 8 years, ganun
mm-hmm.
yun. Until he passed.
Yeah. Okay.
When he passed, doon ko naramdaman na, wow, I really miss doing that, that stage feeling, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So,
and
yung,
so,
nag-umpisa na ako.
So, bumalik ka?
May off. Hindi, uh-huh. andun pa ako eh.
Okay.
May off-Broadway
okay. So what, nag-umpisa kang mag-audition ulit?
Yeah,
uh-huh.
absolutely.
Yeah.
And that from that very first audition after 8 years, which alam kong hindi ko makukuha,
mm-hmm.
pero yung pakiramdam lang na, wow, gusto ko pala talaga to. Mm. I was the happiest guy. Kala mo, nakuha ko yung role eh.
Uh-huh.
Alam ko, hindi ko makukuha eh.
Uh-huh.
In fact,
uh-huh.
inulit ko pa yung monologue ko. Sabi ko,
uh-huh.
excuse me, can I start again? Sabi ko, sure. Sabi nila, there were like 8 people there
uh-huh.
on stage just looking at you and
yeah.
judging you.
Uh-huh.
And there were hundreds auditioning for the same part.
Yes.
Shakespearean
uh-huh.
role kasi.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Everybody
yeah.
wants to do Shakespeare, which
yes.
is cool, you know.
Yeah.
It's cool with me. But I wanted to see if I could do it.
Yeah.
And I was not very good.
Mm.
And I really failed,
mm-hmm.
but for me it was a victory because, you know, parang may na-ignite na naman.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And after that, I took a course, yung mm-hmm. mga crash courses, 3 weeks with this teacher, 2 weeks with that teacher,
mm-hmm.
minsan sabay-sabay habang
mm-hmm.
nagtatrabaho.
Mm-hmm.
Then I auditioned again and I got
mm-hmm.
something.
Mm-hmm.
And then
mm-hmm.
it started there, you know,
mm-hmm.
this off-Broadway
yeah.
things,
uh-oh.
Little plays here and small venues.
Uh-oh.
It was so enjoyable.
Uh-huh.
And parang, wow.
So
I was missing that.
Could you say that acting was still and remains to be your first love?
Yes.
Your passion?
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
It makes me happy.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm
okay.
never happier when I'm, you know, on stage, even
mm.
backstage, just
mm.
rehearsing, even
mm-hmm.
in a room just rehearsing, or
yeah.
on a set, in
mm.
a movie set.
Mm-hmm.
Trip ko talaga.
So what is it
yeah.
about acting that makes it your trip?
I don't know, it feels honest.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Aren't you supposed to be playing somebody else, not yourself?
That's the irony dun eh, di ba? You know, you're somebody else. This may be a fictional story, but at the same time, yung elements na pinag-uusapan at in-explore ng author through the actors is all about truth. So, I always feel that this, when I see a really good production, that takes me somewhere else. Talaga, it just stays with me for years. Parang I saw so much truth in there. I don't see that in real life.
Yeah.
We're all basically, well, I wouldn't say lying to each other. Hindi naman tayo nagsisungaling sa isa't isa. But we can only tell the truth so much. Whereas stage and film, or even a book will tell you, a good book will tell you what's true, eh? Even if it hurts. Diba? So, yun.
Ironic.
I like the irony.
Okay, so as a Filipino actor making it in New York, can you give us some examples of, say, like, mga rude awakenings na nangyari sa'yo discrimination, which of course everybody will deny, but it still exists.
Yung discrimination happens.
Stereotyping.
But the stereotyping is like, until now, that happens. That really happens until now. I mean, I went through a couple of agents na...
Wala ka pang binubukas na linya, eh, sinasabi ng, okay, thank you, you're not what we, you know, what we had in mind,
That happened a couple of times. And even if they don't open their mouth to tell you na thank you, parang nakikita mo na alam mo na eh. After a while, nasanay na ako na hindi ako hinahanap nito mga to. Pero ang biggest dilemma ko doon, sinabi ko doon sa naging isang manager ko doon at sa isang agent ko doon is, padala mo ako doon sa mga auditions, maski puti ang hinahanap nila. Kasi baka mabago natin yung isip nila eh. Kundi naman race-specific to eh. Nakalagay lang, nakalagay white, pero kung basahin mo doon sa script, he could be anybody. Hindi ganun talaga eh. American audience yan eh. Ayaw nila yung nakukonfuse sila. Maski pag ang call nga, pang Asian,
yes,
yung isip nilang Asian look, hindi yung Asian look sa atin, eh?
Yes.
Ang iniisip nila, Japanese, Chinese, Korean. You know what I mean? It's a different look. Para hindi sila ma-confuse. So madaming beses na, yun, if you could call it a rude awakening, to me, it's just a realistic awakening that's the market there. What are you gonna do?
Pero may pagbabago na ba? Or wala pa rin pagbabago?
Sa tingin ko, wala pa rin eh.
Wala pa rin. Talagang,
wala pa rin. Yung mga... The actors and even directors that I got close to, who were of our race, you know, or even partly our race, even Latino, nandun pa rin sila. And they tell me, it's still the same laban all over again. And you know, after a while, you get tired of that, you know, na parang, you know, why not go back to your own country where you're not gonna get stereotyped? Iba yung typing naman sa'yo. You know, I mean, pwede ka bang tatay, pwede ka bang secret agent, you know, or pwede kang pareho. You know, yun yung naman ang typing. Okay lang yun, I understand that. Pero yung race typing, I didn't like that part.
So ano yung race typing? Ano yung mga tipong stereotype roles na usually binibigay sa isang Asian actor?
Functional roles, doctor, nurse, pharmacist. Ang pinakagusto kong role na nabigay sa akin, and yet they were still typing, gusto nila medyo Asian ba o Latino, was that role nga in Criminal Intent, sa Law and Order Criminal Intent, because he was a murder suspect who drives a truck for a movie company. Pero akala niya si James Dean siya. Kaya may cowboy hat siya at red jacket. So, quirky.
Yeah.
Sabi ko, trip ko to. All right. You know, it's a good thing na kumuha ko rin. Because they wanted somebody who can be James Deanish na, na medyo weird ng konti. So, yun. The other roles are like, okay, I mean, forensics expert, you know, it's like, no real challenge, but it's a job. Trabaho pa rin yan, you know, and it's hard to get the work there. That's why talagang, and New York pa naman is mostly theater. So talagang teatro ka ng teatro ng teatro. Minsan magti-TV ka, okay, ilan lang yung sinushoot dun. Pero teatro ka ng teatro, dapat.
And is theater still your first love?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Iba talaga yung high. Iba
yung... So is that why you came back?
No, I came back after shooting the Kitchen musical in Singapore.
Okay.
Because I like being here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yung trips ko every year, talagang gusto kong nandito ako. Gusto ko yung init, gusto ko yung ulan, gusto ko yung amoy, gusto ko yung mga tao. Lahat gusto ko eh.
Mm-hmm.
You know, talagang, imagine 20 plus years ako sa New York, yeah. I never felt at home.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I just felt like I was visiting for 20 plus years.
Okay.
I never felt at home.
Uh-huh.
I never felt like that walking through Central Park was my thing. You know, I mean, it's a nice park, but I would rather walk along Manila Bay, you know, or even just the grounds of the CCP area. Mas happy ako dun eh. Why? You know, you can't
explain
that.
So is it safe to say you're back for good?
If I can help it, yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Wow.
For as long as I can get work here, active pa rin yung agent ko dun eh. Medyo napipikon sa akin. Basta sabi ko, you know.
Tumatawag na siya, kailan ka babalik?
You know,
ang daming audition dito.
Like I got offered something for Lincoln Center. You know, nice Broadway thing and stuff like that. I didn't like the role eh. You know, I didn't like the role. But of course, yung attack nila from a business point of view. But Art, you're gonna make this much week. Nah, I'm okay here. You know, I'm doing some guestings on TV. I prefer that.
Okay.
Plus, I can think in my language. At makakasalita ako sa lingwahe ko. You know, nami-miss ko rin yan.
Yes.
Eh. Yung switch. Sa
I completely understand.
Diba?
Okay, yeah. Marami pa po tayong pag-uusapan tungkol sa multi-awarded stage film and television actor na si Art Acuña. Dito pa rin sa Art to Art. Magbabalik po kami pagkatapos na ilang paalala.
Programang hatid ay sining at kulturang para sa lahat. Magbabalik ang Art to Art. Schedule ng mga inaabang ang konsyerto. Update sa mga magagandang panoorin sa mga tanghalan at teatro. Narito na ang Art to Art Calendar.
Narito ang ating arts calendar. Sa Sining Biswal, isasagawa ni Manuel Manix Abrera ang kanyang one-person exhibition na pinamagatang 14 Silent Comics sa George B. Vargas Museum, UP Diliman, Quezon City mula August 5 hanggang August 19. Tampok sa kanyang mga obra ang mga characters mula sa Philippine mythology tulad ng Manananggal, White Lady, Duwende at Kapre. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa Vargas Museum 928-1927 o mag-email vargasmuseum@gmail.com. Sa teatro, muling inihahandog ng Manila Shakespeare Company ang inaugural production nito ng Romeo and Juliet. Magkakaroon ng palabas sa teatrino sa Promenade ng Green Hills, August 7, 8, August 14 at August 15, alas 8 ng gabi. Gaganap sa pangunahing papel sina Nelsito Gomez at Rachel Coates. Kabilang din sa cast sina Maynard Peñalosa, Isa Litton, Katsky Flores, Miko Yabut at Jonas Gruet. Para sa ticket, tumawag o mag-text 0939-596-9250 o mag-email sa mnlshakesco@gmail.com. Samantala, inihahandog ng City of Coronadal sa pakikipagtulungan ng Cultural Center of the Philippines, Department of Tourism at ng National Commission for Culture and the Arts ang kauna-unahang Coronadal International Folklore Festival na binansagang Piesta Colon Datal na gaganapin sa CCP, Rojas Boulevard, CCP Complex mula August 9 hanggang August 18. Ang mga kalahok na bansa ay Armenia, Chinese Taipei, India, Indonesia, Japan, Mexico, Poland, Russia, Slovenia, Sri Lanka, Thailand at Turkey. Tampok din ang apat na grupo mula sa Pilipinas, ang UP Filipiniana Dance Group, PNU Kislap Sining Dance Troupe, Philippine Barangay Folk Dance Troupe, ECD Dance Company of the Philippines at Coronadal Hinugyaw Cultural Dance Troupe. Magtatanghal sila ng mga traditional songs at dances. Magkakaroon din ng pocket performances at lecture demonstrations.
Usapang sining at kultura para sa lahat. Kasama ang balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Makuha. Art to Art.
Kasama pa rin natin ang multi-awarded actor na si Art Acuña dito sa Art to Art.
Yes.
Okay. Art, before we broke for commercial, you said that you decided to come back sa Manila pagkatapos mong magtrabaho sa Singapore. Mm-hmm. So, tell us about yung the kitchen musical in Singapore. Anong project ito? Mm-hmm. It was TV, yes? A TV series?
Yes, it was a TV series mm-hmm. na nag-audition ako para sa kitchen musical nung pumunta sila dito.
Mm-hmm.
Nag-audition sila ng maraming tao sa ABS-CBN. And at that time, nandito ako doing a film for Loy Arsenas, yung Nino.
Mm-hmm.
So during Nino, actually patapos na eh. Uuwi na ako. Mm-hmm. Siguro last two days, and then I fly after that. May tumawag sa akin from Atlantis Theater Company, si Lisa Camus,
mm-hmm.
who's not in good shape right now. Mm-hmm. And she's a good friend of mine, yeah. Mm-hmm. Sabi niya, Art, there's a musical they want to shoot in Singapore. Kung gusto mo, like that. And you can sing enough, right? Mm-hmm. Sabi ko, well, yeah, but I've never sung on TV, mm-hmm. you know. Sabi ko, I don't know how to do those things. Sabi niya, you'll figure it out. You should go. I'll get you a slot. Kasi by invitation only.
Okay.
So it was, umuwi ako ng 5 in the morning from that film shoot on mm-hmm. the day of the audition.
Mm-hmm.
Nag-decide ako, hindi na ako pupunta eh.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, putya, yun naman ako, hindi ako sanay. Nag-musical theater ako, pero hindi forte. You know, I mean, ayaw mong mapahiya yung mga taong nag-recommend sa'yo, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, pero yung fiancé ko, si Maritina,
mm-hmm.
told me you should go. You should go and just enjoy it. And at this time, at 6 o'clock in the morning, may beer na ako. Nagbibira ako para makatulog ako eh. So I drink one beer, so I, like my brain would shut off and I could catch up on some sleep, no?
Yeah.
I go, oh man, okay. And at that time, I was living in Malate, very close to CCP.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So I got on my motorcycle, and then I go, I don't even have a song. Okay. And then I go, okay, they want something pop, rock, something like that. So I started to sing as I was riding all the way to ABS-CBN just to rehearse it.
Mm-hmm.
But I think what got me the job naman is the sides, the role. Nakita ko from the sides already. Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's all a guess, you know. Mm-hmm. You've never read the script, but I think I guessed right.
Yeah, can you tell us about that role?
Yeah, it was about the role was the general manager of the restaurant.
Okay.
Uh-huh. You know, the lead is played by my inaanak, Karil Tatlonghari, you know. And she is the lead character at of course they've shown it already. It turns out pala I'm her real father. You know, because I had an affair with her mother. So, yung nagpapanggap na tatay niyang foreigner, you know, who's a British guy, hindi pala siya yun. Pero siya yung boss namin eh. Siya yung boss ko rin eh. So, yun, that's part of the intrigue. It's like a glee for adults, I think. Yeah, and it was really fun to do.
And really, how did you feel about the singing?
Oh, I enjoyed it.
Uh-huh.
I really enjoyed it. Yeah, I did. And the actual work, yung nasa studio ka, you'll record it, and then kakantahin mo live pag shooting na. You know, you can sing it soft, eh, sabi ko, do you mind if I sing it loud para huli-huli mo yung breath?
Oh, yung bigay na bigay, no?
Oh, di ba? Minsan nakahalata mo yun sa dubbed singing. Mm-hmm. Yung intensity ng moment dun, para bang something's off. Doon mo nahalata na, no, they're not really singing. You don't want them to notice you're not singing.
Yeah.
You want the audience to think you're singing.
Mm-hmm.
So you might as well sing it na. Yeah. Sabayan mo ng mabuti yung ginawa mo doon sa studio.
Uh-oh.
You know what I mean?
And for that role, you got nominated for the International Emmys in 2012.
Yeah.
So what was that experience like?
It was Karil who called me up at 11:30 at night. I didn't even know about it.
Okay.
I didn't know about it.
Uh-huh.
So she called and she goes, "Hi, congratulations." She goes like that. Uh-huh. "Thank you for what?" Really? I mean, like that. Uh-huh. And I was wondering, what's an international Emmy? Uh-huh. Alam ko lang yung Emmy dun sa ano. I told you I don't watch a lot of TV. You know, so
nagpunta ka sa awards night?
No, I was working.
So hindi ka nagpunta sa New York?
No, okay. I didn't go. I'd rather work. Yeah,
okay.
I like working.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's one thing. Working with the acting thing really makes me happy. Just that one thing. Just kind of sad and immature, but, you know, other things should make you happy. What are you going to do?
Okay. Okay.
Di ba? Di ba yung mga payo ng mga taong nagsusulat ng mga libro and stuff from the States, sabi nila, kung artist ka, you know what? Take the risk, take the plunge, that's what makes you happy, you just do that and the hell with everything. You know, that's easier said than done. Yeah. You can't really do that. You know, sometimes you're responsible for other people. Mm-hmm. You know, so you've got to balance it. Yeah, you can pursue it, but there may come a point in your life that you might have to sacrifice your life because you've got other people to take care of. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So far naman, the juggling has been good. Mm. If it ever comes to that, I'll give it up. You know, if that's what it takes because I'm responsible for other people, I'll give it up.
Mm-hmm. Which you've done before.
Which I've done before anyway. Yeah. Absolutely. And I convinced myself, I hated it. Yeah, those 8 years, I told myself, this acting thing, that's for vain people who are, have nothing better to do. They can't paint, they can't, you know, they can't sing, they can't build a house. That's why they do that and use themselves. I told myself that for 8 years. And I really learned to dislike it. I didn't even watch any movies.
So you were acting in your real life?
I guess so. Yeah. I guess so. You know, the restaurant business, yung, the floor behind the bar, you know, managing it. It's like a kind of theater. Eh? You're actually role-playing all the time with different kinds of customers. And boy, ang dami kong nakilala. Iba-ibang klaseng customers. Ki mafia nakilala ko yung mga they wanted to take me upstate to make me their head bartender.
Oh, okay.
Ante, we really, they kiss me pa when they walk into the place.
So that was,
kinikiss pa ako. Oh, God.
Magandang ano yan. Magandang research yan para sa acting.
Ay,
pinag-aralan
ko sila talaga. Three of them na imprison, they were na-tape sila sa isang restaurant na papatayin si John Gotti. Of course, they're the ones who, they were in jail when the real killing happened.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah. I saw these guys almost every day between the hours of 7 and midnight. They're at my bar. Yeah, because it's a very Italian bar.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
Ang dami kong kwento, but that's gonna take four hours.
No, sige, pero konti lang ang panahon natin. Dito naman sa Pilipinas, mas marami kang parang projects with indie films kesa sa mainstream. Is that by choice?
Actually, hindi naman conscious choice yun eh. Yun lang talagang lumalapit. And if I like the script, you know, hindi ako yung... Wag na, mag-intay muna tayo, baka mas malaking project darating. Nah, I like it eh, let's do it now. Ganun din ako sa play. Kung mauna yung play, then sacrifice the TV and stuff like that, you know. It hurts sometimes financially, but you'll always make it back. That's how I feel eh, you know. You can't base it on the fee. I mean, it's a consideration because we're practical people, di ba? But if it come, if it's there and you want to do it.
Kumbaga, if it's a role na gusto mong gawin, kahit na ang bayad ay konti lang, gagawin mo.
Of course. Basis na nangyari yun, sure, yeah, absolutely.
So no regrets?
No regrets with what?
With all your choices. Meron ka bang role na tinanggap na you regretted accepting? Or meron, vice versa, meron ka bang role na... hindi ka mag-audition
meron
tapos nag-regret ka din.
Meron. May isang pelikula na lahat naman kami ng cast, binuhos namin yung kaluluwa namin para doon sa project na yun. Pero hindi pa rin maganda lumabas. Hindi namin maintindihan kung bakit. Para bang lahat ng pinaghirapan namin, ang ganda ng rushes eh. Pag nakita mo talaga, alam mo, patama yung ginagawa mo eh. And we were talking to each other all the time because we were in a different place. So isolated kayo dun sa location for a week, you know. So yun lang ang pag-uusapan nyo, how to make it good, how to make it great. You know, why be mediocre when you can be great? Always shoot for that. You know, so, pero ang yung finished product, we have no control of that. Yung finished product, nakaka-dismaya nung nakita ko talaga. I mean, yung sama ng loob ko, hindi na, and this was, nung nag-open sa CCP, hindi ako sumali dun sa cast nung nagpa-picture siya sa ibang tao. Hindi sa kinahihiya ko sila. Pero ayoko makaharap yung nagtapos ng pelikula kasi baka may may lumabas galing sa akin na hindi ko gustong lumabas.
Baka mamaya masuntok mo.
Oo. I don't know. So umuwi na lang ako at binuksan ko yung bote ko ng tequila at nagsalita ako sa sarili ko, bakit ganun? Review ko lahat habang umiinom ako ng tequila. Yun na lang. And then later on, months later, you find out ganun din pala yung pakiramdam ng iba. And I'm thinking, kung ganun pala yung pakiramdam nyo, paano kayong... Yung politics and posing with the pictures and stuff like that, I don't get that. If you don't feel honest about it, why are you going to do it? Why?
Yeah, that's true.
It doesn't feel good.
So is there anything you miss about working in the States now that you're back?
The people. Uh-huh. I met some really good people. Mm-hmm. You know, I worked with some actors also with names that they're always either in a movie or, you know, on TV and stuff like that. And they turned out to be really nice. I did some good projects over there, especially theater, that I really, really enjoyed. One of them is Whisper House, which was a musical by Duncan Sheik. He had some top 40 hit a long time ago, and then he started to do all these musical things. But they were looking for an Asian guy to play that one Asian role in the thing, and I got it. May singing ng konti. Yun na naman, the irony, ano? You know, it's about World War II, it's about a love affair, and that was taboo between the white woman who owned the lighthouse and the Japanese guy who was manning the lighthouse. Sabali, employee niya. So, but it also involved ghosts. There were ghosts. The place was haunted. So yun, most of the singing was done by the ghosts in the background when you'd see them. They would sing in the mic and they're dressed. Ang ganda lumabas eh. And we did that in three different places, New York, San Diego, and another place. But I did Romance of Magno Rubio in New York. You know, that that's like, to me, that's a gem. Hindi mawawala yan sa puso ko. These Phil-Am guys, especially Jojo Gonzalez. You know? Yeah. Oh my God. And Orlando Paboto. They're terrific, talented. Pero doon ang buhay nila. Hindi na uuwi yung mga yan. Hindi na.
But what can you say about yung parang, Philippine theater scene is actually thriving.
It is thriving. It is thriving.
Well, what can you say about that? Is it something that you're here also because there's so much opportunity now?
Oh yeah.
Sa Philippine theater?
Of course, that's always a consideration. Unfortunately, the last three times I've been asked to do a play, I was stuck in TV. You know, so I don't want to create a conflict. Nangyari na sa akin yun, and it was a bad scene. that kind of conflict thing, it makes people angry. So, yeah, I mean, it's all over the place. There's so many groups, you know, they're all trying their own tone with the type of theater they want to do. And bravo! To me, that's sige lang. Kailangan natin yan noon pa.
What about a dream role? Or a dream project that you've always wanted to do?
Oh, wow, it might be too late. You know, I'm not a... I don't know. I can think of only one. I've always wanted to do Cyrano. Either on film or on stage. Cyrano de Bergerac. I don't know why.
Why would you
say it's
too late?
I think maybe I know why. Sakit na yung likod ko. And then, no. Kaya ko pa siguro.
Kaya pa yan.
Otherwise, I have no favorite dream role, except for that one. That's always the one that comes up to my head. Pag tinanong ako, anong classical piece ang gusto mong gawin? Hindi Shakespeare ang sasabihin ko. Cyrano pa rin ang sasabihin ko. So, yun lagi ang naiisip ko.
Okay, last question, Art. Yung mga aspiring actors na nakikinig sa atin ngayon, kahit bata pa sila or teenagers or maybe even in their early 20s when you first decided to leave to go to the US, anong advice mo sa kanila?
Advice, kung gusto niyo talaga, kung gusto mo talaga yung art mo. Pag-aralan mo palagi. So maski nanonood ka lang ng TV sa bahay, kasi the moment na maging actor ka, hindi ka na audience eh. Lagi mong pinag-aaralan yung pinanonood mo. At kung meron kang napapanood na moving, at nakikiliti yung loob mo, di ba?
pag-aralan mo kung ano yung ginagawa nila, not just the acting, pag-aralan mo lahat kung bakit naging effective sila. At kung meron kang mananakaw na technique from them at magawa mong sa'yo, na bagay sa'yo, gamitin mo. Yun din ang sabi ni Michael Caine. There's a popular series niya on acting. That sila Brando and everybody, they stole that from somebody else, you know, and made it their own. That's why you don't notice it. So he said that. It's true.
Yeah.
He
so,
really said
so
that.
So be a good, attentive audience member first.
Correct. Your mind doesn't stop
studying.
So all
good actors have to be good audience members first.
Correct. Correct. You never turn off the acting instinct. You know, you're not going to say, ah, okay, tapos na yung rehearsal, uwi muna ako, let's drink, have fun. No, there's you study life around you, you know, there's things that happen.
Yeah.
So that's on all the time. You're absorbing things all the time. You know, and go after the go after what's solidly important about portraying a role. Don't go for the celebrity-dom afterwards. You have no control over that. You know, wala kang control dyan. Don't go for awards or anything like that. That doesn't mean anything. It's what happens there at that moment. You either film it or it's a night on stage. That's not going to come back.
That's
just go through that journey.
Yeah.
That's the trip.
Follow your heart, follow your passion.
Correct.
Kung saan ka masaya.
Correct. Also, one more, second advice. No? Have a fallback plan.
Okay.
Be good at something else too. You know, even if it's just a hobby. Me, I'm good with motorcycles. I can take apart a motorcycle and put it back. You know what I mean? I can customize a bike.
So, meron na tayong art repair shop.
Hey, that's my dream actually.
Okay. Oh, isa yan sa panaginip.
Yeah.
Oh, lahat naman nag-uumpisa sa panaginip, di ba?
That's true.
Okay. Well, maraming salamat, Art.
Salamat din.
Yeah, for being our guest here in Art.
In-interview ako ng isang icon.
Oh, diba?
Imagine that. That's really a trip for me.
Okay.
Thank you, Lisa.
Sandali lang. Bago tayo magtapos, babatiin ko ng happy birthday, syempre, ang aking writer, Angie Ureta. Happy birthday, August 2, head writer of Art to Art. And we just finished Art to Art with Art. Hanggang sa susunod na linggo, samahan ninyo kami ulit dito sa Art to Art, kung saan ang usapang sining at kultura ay para sa lahat. Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Makuha, nagpupugay sa artistang Pilipino.